الحمد لله رب العالمين، صلى الله وسلم على محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. My dear respected brothers and sisters, inshallah ta'ala, we're going to continue from where we left off. We are studying this tremendous book by this great imam, the imam of al-sunnah wal-jama'ah, al-imam al-barbahari, rahimahullahu ta'ala. And his book is well known to you, which is called The Explanation of the Creed. The Explanation of the Creed. قال المؤلف رحمه الله وعلم أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال ستفترق أمتي على 73 فرقة كلها في النار إلا واحدة وهي الجماعة. قيل من هم يا رسول الله؟ قال ما أنا عليه اليوم وأصحابي. The author, rahimahullah, he said, know that the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that my ummah, my Muslim community, my nation, will be divided into 73 sects. All of it is in the fire except one. And that is al-jama'ah. That is al-jama'ah. And it was said to him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there's another narration, it was said to him, who are they? So he said, alayhi salatu wa salam, those who are upon what I am upon today and my companions. Those who are upon what I am upon today and my companions. Because now when you look around and you see that we have so many sects in the Muslim land, we have so many deviant sect. We have the Sufiya, then we have the Muslim Brotherhood, then we have the Tablighis, then we have also Jama'at Hizb al-Tahrir and the Khawarij, and other than them from the people of Bid'ah. There's so many of them, right? The Brilwis, the Diobandis, and other than them, right? So all these sects that are out there, they are deviant sect. Why? Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said all of it will be in the fire except one. Except one. He did not say all of them will be in Jannah. He said all of them will be in the fire except one. So the one that will be saved is the one who is upon what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his companions were upon. And may Allah make us from them. الشيخ صالح بن فوزان الفوزان حفظه الله تعالى he said وقوله واعلم أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال ستفترق أمتي على 73 فرقة كلها في النار إلا واحدة وهي الجماعة. He said the statement of the author رحمه الله الإمام البربهاري, know that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that his ummah will be divided into 73 sects. All of it will be in the fire except one, and it is al-jama'ah. It is al-jama'ah. طيب. Sheikh Saleh Fuzan, حفظه الله تعالى, he said, Allah jalla wa ala amarana bi-ijtima' ala al-haq. He said, Allah has commanded us to unite upon the truth. To unite upon the truth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. Surah Al-Imran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. And hold on all of you together to the rope of Allah and do not be divided. And do not be divided. And he also said, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ فَرَّقُوا دِينَهُمْ وَكَانُوا شِيَعًا لَسْتَ مِنْهُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ إِنَّمَا أَمْرُهُمْ إِلَى اللَّهِ ثم ينبئهم بما كانوا يفعلون. He said, سبحانه وتعالى, إن الذين فرقوا دينهم. As for those who divided their religion into sect, وكانوا شيعا, and they were parties. لست منهم في شيء. You have nothing to do with them. You have nothing to do with them. Their affair rests with Allah. إنما أمرهم إلى الله. Their affair rests with Allah. ثم ينبئهم بما كانوا يفعلون. Then he will inform them of about that which they used to do. Which they used to do. Surah Al-An'am. And he also says, وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ تَفَرَّقُوا وَاخْتَلَفُوا مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا جَاءَتْهُمُ الْبَيِّنَاتُ وَأُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ عَظِيمٌ سورة الإمران. And do not be like those who divided among themselves and differed after guidance, after clear guidance has come to them. After clear guidance has come to them. And those they will have a great punishment. They will have a great punishment. May Allah protect us from that. فنهانا عن التفرق وأمرنا بالاجتماع والاعتصام بكتاب الله وسنة رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He commanded us to be united. He commanded us to be united. And He forbade us, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He forbade us from differing and being divided, from being disunited and divided. And He commanded us to be united. And He commanded us to hold on fast to the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَقَالَ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِ مُسْتَقِيمًا فَاتَّبِعُوهُ وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلَ فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also said, the meaning of which, and this is my straight path, so follow it. And do not follow other paths, because they will mislead you away from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Surah Al-An'am. فَلَا يَجُوزُ التَّفَرُّقُ وَالْإِخْتِلَافُ تَبَعًا لِلْأَهْوَاءِ أَوْ تَقْلِيدًا لِلْآبَاءِ وَالْأَجْدَادِ أَوْ تَقْلِيدًا لِلْيَهُودِ وَالنَّصَارَى. He said it is not permissible to be divided and to differ following our desires, following the desires. Because some people, they follow their desires. So this is not, the matter is not based on what you think or what you love or what you desire. The matter is based upon what is in the Kitab and the Sunnah, what Allah said and what His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. Or to blindly follow the forefathers, because some people, if you tell them you this is the truth, they say, well, our forefathers were upon this. How can we leave it? You see, because they have this fanaticism towards what their forefathers were upon. طيب. And also al-ajdad, the ancestors, what they were upon, and the ancestors, what they were upon. Or blind following and following the Jews and the Christians. الاختلاف لا يجوز في أمور العقيدة وأصول الدين وإنما يجب الاتفاق والاجتماع عليها. He said it is not permissible to differ when it comes to the affairs of عقيدة, affairs of the creed, the عقيدة, and the foundations of the religions. The foundations of the religion is عقيدة, because the religion is based upon التوحيد والإيمان والعقيدة. نعم. These are the foundation. These are the foundation of the religion. The Islam is based upon that, and that's why, when you look at the five pillars of Islam, the first pillar is usul al-din, the fundamental principles of the deen, is the true testification of faith, and Islam is based upon it. Islam is based upon the true testimony of faith. Likewise, when you look at the six pillars of Iman, you find that they are based upon usul ad-din. Usul ad-din, the fundamental principle of the deen. Fundamental principles of the deen. طيب. The Shaykh حفظه الله تعالى, he said, وإنما يجب الاتفاق والاجتماع عليها. What is upon us is to be united, and to hold on fast upon that, وأما الاختلاف في المسائل الفقهية فهذا يحصل ولكن يجب الرجوع إلى ما قام عليه الدليل من الأقوال. He said, as for differing when it comes to المسائل الفقهية, the issues of fiqh, jurisprudence, issues of fiqh. Like for example, this scholar, he said, for example, it's permissible, the other one said it's impermissible, and the like. So in this case, the sheikh said, we refer our affair to the proof and evidence. Whoever has the proof and evidence, we take his opinion. Whether it is with Abu Hanifa, rahimahullah, or it is with Imam Malik, or Imam Shafi, or Imam Ahmad, or Al-Awza'i, or Sufyan ibn Sa'id al-Thawri, or late ibn Sa'd, or any of the Imams of Fiqh and Hadith. Naam. طيب. The Shaykh, he said, قال تعالى فإن تنازعتم في شيء فردوه إلى الله والرسول إن كنتم تؤمنون بالله واليوم الآخر ذلك خير وأحسن تأويلا. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us in this particular ayah in Surah An-Nisa, when we differ, he said, if you differ, the meaning of which, if you differ in anything, then refer it back to Allah and His Messenger. If you truly believe in Allah and the last day. So this ayah is a proof and evidence that whenever there is a difference of opinion between scholars of fiqh, then what do? We return this affair to the book of Allah and the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah. So the scholar who has that dalil with him. For example, a scholar, he used an ayah from the Quran, or he used a hadith from Sahih Bukhari. Another scholar, he did not have access to that hadith, for example. He did not have access to the hadith. So, or he used a weak hadith. So, of course, the scholar who used the sound hadith is the one that has the evidence with him. And his evidence is stronger. And the other one, his evidence is weak. So we take the evidence that is stronger and we leave the evidence that is weak. The Shaykh said, إذن الاختلاف في العقيدة لا يجوز لأن العقيدة توقيفية ليس محل اجتهاد. He said, therefore, when it comes to differing in عقيدة, it is not permissible. Why? Because العقيدة توقيفية. توقيفية means it is restricted to الكتاب والسنة. It is restricted to the text. If you don't have a text, you cannot use your own opinion. You cannot say, well, Ahl al-Bid'ah, the people of Ahl al-Bid'ah, they use their own opinion, their own intellect, intellectual reasoning. Intellectual, like for example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has hands that befits His majesty. That befits His majesty. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He mentioned in the Quran, like for example, He said, بَلْ يَدَاهُمْ مَبْسُوطَتَانِ. His hands are outstretched. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He mentioned this. So now the people of bid'ah, the people of innovation, they come and they interpret, or I should say misinterpret the ayah according to their intellectual reasoning, And they say, no, it doesn't mean hands, it means powers or favors. You see, these are from the innovations. These are from the, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He did not mention that His hand or His powers or His favors or the like. Now, so the affairs of al-aqidah, they have to be taken from al-Qur'an wal-hadith. They have to be taken from the Qur'an wal-hadith. There is no difference of opinion among the people of al-sunnah when it comes to al-aqidah. They don't differ in anything when it comes to al-aqidah. Sahaba, they did not differ in anything concerning al-aqidah. Nothing. So anyone who has said that the Sahaba differed in Aqidah, let him bring the proof and evidence. Let him bring it. He's not going to find any. So the Sahaba and the Tabi'een, Itba' al-Tabi'een, the Salaf al-Salih, until our time, they all agree. There is unanimous agreement when it comes to the affairs of Aqidah. They all agree upon them. They all agree upon the fundamental principles of belief. They all affirm to Allah what He affirmed to Himself in the Quran and what His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam affirmed to Him in the sound hadith. So inshallah, up to here, we're going to take a break. We're going to stop and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us all ilm al-nafi' wal-amal salih. Alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala muhammadin وآله وصحبه وسلم، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.